Welcome to Nerdist Podcast number 594. What a week! We did some Talking Dead, we went to New York and did some shows for At Midnight. I am posting this podcast a day late, which is very rare for me, but I came back from New York and immediately went to BlizzCon, which was incredible. I was kind of nervous about it because I didn't want to screw it up, and it was... The costumes were amazing, and the crowd was incredible. There were like 12,000 people there, and that Warcraft community was very, very, very nice to me, and I had a blast. So thank you if you were there or took part. And if not, then erase the last 40 seconds from your brain. I would like to thank for sponsoring this episode of Nerdist Podcast, Audible. Audible, as you probably know, is a leading provider of premium digital spoken audio information and entertainment on the internet. If you've listened to an audiobook, it probably was from Audible. They have a library of over 150,000 titles. You can get individual books, or for real savings, you can sign up for an Audible listener program, which will give you book credits each month for a low monthly fee. Then you can download your choices, access them on your PC, burn them onto CDs if you still use those, upload them into your iPhones or whatever your MP3 players might be. It's quick, it's easy, it's fun, it's affordable entertainment for people of all ages, from 4 to 94, from 1 to 1,000. If you're 1,000 years old, you could still enjoy these things. The history books would be like your contemporary newspapers, if that makes any sense to you. But that is audiblepodcast.com/nerdist. You're going to go to that. You're going to get a free audiobook and a 30-day trial. Might I suggest, let's say, Jim Gaffigan's Dad is Fat, which is his newest book. He was amazing on At Midnight this week. So there you go. audiblepodcast.com/nerdist. Free audiobook and a 30-day trial. This episode is OK Go, which was one of our first podcasts, maybe number 12? I think we went to Damien's house, and when we had our giant archaic equipment set up, which we've slimmed down just a little bit. But I can't believe it's already been like 4+ years since these guys were on. But their new album is called Hungry Ghosts. It's out now, and Damien, Tim, and Andy are in the interview, and such sweet, hilarious, cool, innovative, wonderful chaps. So it was really good to have them back, and then they actually play a song at the end, so stick around for the Nerdist. And if you haven't seen I Won't Let You Down yet, the new video, you absolutely should, because it is another triumph in the pantheon of OK Go, we're figuring out how to make good YouTube videos. So here it is, Nerdist Podcast number 594 with OK Go. Okay, go. Listen to the podcast.
Now entering Nerdist.com.
I love your Taj Mahal sweater.
Thank you.
That is an amazing sweater, Tim.
I appreciate that.
And I'm also excited that, as we were saying kind of before, you were on one of the very first episodes of this podcast. You believed in us when no one knew even what a podcast was.
And we still do. I still don't know what a podcast is.
I think we're trying to figure it out.
I have no idea.
It's an internet radio broadcast without the radio.
Like SiriusXM U?
No, that's a station. Just mentioned a very specific station.
Is that with the satellite?
Mm-hmm. That's in the air.
That's in the air, yeah.
That's right.
Space is not nice to people.
Don't do well up there.
I've never been to space, but people tell me that there's like no air out there at all.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But first of all, uncool, right?
Very, well, very, very cold.
Okay, yes. But I mean like in the Fonzie sense, like very uncool.
Yeah, no. It's like even Fonzie, I bet you he could do that, like that snap and everything.
And then he'd be okay.
I don't think so.
What?
That's the thing, is I think, like, outer space...
If he snapped, you wouldn't
listen,
hear it.
Again, listen, I shouldn't talk about it. I've never been there.
I wouldn't even be able to hear the snap.
But I think... Yeah,
that's how uncool it is.
I think... Well, you'd be able to hear it at very low frequencies. I think at incredibly low frequencies.
But how is it going
to
travel?
You and I and wouldn't pick it up, though.
No, we wouldn't pick it up. Like, they released that all those, like those sounds of Saturn, like all those super low...
Oh, right.
Low,
I heard that. You know, that was a classic.
Yeah, but that is not Saturn snapping, is the thing. Saturn, Saturn doesn't even have arms.
No, that's like electromagnetic waves.
I would say...
Yeah, it's more that.
I would say Venus is probably the Fonzie planet.
How so?
I don't know.
Venus is a woman, right? Isn't that the whole point?
Yeah. If anyone, it would be Mars.
You think so?
Yeah. Mm.
Yeah.
No,
men are from Mars, and who's the ultimate man?
Yeah,
Fonzie.
And where are women from?
He's only part man.
Yeah, right, that's right. Well, that's now.
Just to finish the quote.
For some reason, I thought you said Darth Hader, like Bill Hader went over to the dark side.
Darth Hader is awesome. I hope he goes
Bill
as
Hader
that
became
for,
a Sith.
I hope he goes as that for Halloween.
Oh, my God, you've just given me my Halloween color.
Yeah, that's a perfect Halloween.
Totally, Darth Hader. Do you know what Tim was last year?
What?
I was Pharaoh Fawcett.
What?
Yeah. I dressed up like a pharaoh and put a faucet through my pharaoh.
That is fucking amazing.
Yeah. It was good.
I did Luke Skywalker Texas Ranger this year.
You've had that idea for a while.
I've had it before, but I almost did Prince Leia, which was like Princess Leia, but then purple with
great idea.
That's a really good one.
See, but it was too much. It was too much.
Are you doing anything to dressing up tonight?
I think tonight I'll just do the Luke Skywalker one.
So you already have the
That's
outfit.
Good. I want to dress in all winter gray and then from the neck down be in winter gray and then on the top look like Elvis and be Elvis Priusley.
Oh, that's
that could be pretty good.
You know what? The love-hate relationship I have with weird conceptual mashup costumes is that people. You know, it's just like the dude at a party's like, "What, space cowboy?" And I'm like, "No."
That is the problem.
And you got to explain it.
Oh,
I get it.
Right.
I had a really bad pun one that I thought the failure of the joke was the success of the joke. You know, mm-hmm. And no one, not a single person who saw me that year or I've told about it has ever found it amusing except myself. I'm gonna try you because
it's
nerdy.
Please.
I had a wristband. It was Velcro on it, and I Velcroed a small box on there, and then I went to a party, and I drank a bunch, and when people asked me what I was, I said, I'm drinking outside the box.
Amazing!
You were the only two people who ever found that amusing.
That's like you're hanging out with the wrong people. I
know. I will never go to that party again.
One year,
won't.
Right after college, I went to I got this basically a sweatsuit, and I glued all of this tinsel to it.
Mm-hmm.
So it was just all like transparent tinsel, but it when it caught the light, it had this reflective quality, and. I was a Halls Mentholyptus vapor action. Like I was the
you were the vapor action.
I was the vapor action from the old Halls commercials.
That's I never awesome. Got that conceptual.
Did not fly. Did
I've
not
only
fly.
Like it's like the past couple of years. It's like my wife and I have done couples costumes, which I normally hate, but she's really good at coming up with them. And
also, you got to do them because she's your wife.
You have to do them. Yeah. You have to. But knowing it, we always have to explain them. Like last year, we were Simon and Hecubus from Kids in the Hall.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah. We had to keep on telling people that. Yeah. And then the year before that, we were Chainsaw and Dave from Summer School. Mm. Another thing we had to keep on mentioning to people.
Yeah.
Before that, we were the Master and Torgo from Manos Hands of Fate, the one of the best episodes of Mystery. See, I lost you guys at that one.
Yeah, you didn't. Yeah. He didn't lose me.
Yeah, you didn't
lose you.
I'm on board. Yeah. I saw
we're
it at Disneyland last Friday for the Halloween party. I saw two dudes who, and I was so delighted that they did this because I know that there might have been four people in the park who got this reference. They were dead Bill and Ted from Bogus Journey. They were all black and white Bill and Ted.
That's good. That's good.
I was very impressed by the reference and the commitment.
I somehow ended up at a party once where I saw Michel Gondry and he was dressed as a question mark. And I thought, man, that's so French.
Yeah.
So French.
Was it someone dressed up like Michel Gondry or was it actually Michel Gondry?
I was told it was actually him.
Oh my God, that's what you should be, Tim. You should be Michel Gondry as a question mark.
That's good.
You should be Michel Gondry as an exclamation point and find actual Michel Gondry and then go as an interrobang. Like you could just stand next to the right of him.
That's good.
Yes. I think that's the way to do that.
I had to advise on a costume for Jamie Ziegelbaum a couple years ago, and he didn't have anything. He was my roommate, and I gave him jeans and a jean t-shirt, jean, you know, button down shirt, and then I put Billy Bob Thornton, a picture of Billy Bob Thornton on his chest, and he was Billie Jean.
Yeah.
These are
all good ideas, guys. Yeah.
Yeah. You can do a lot with little. You just need to like puns.
I hope you're recording.
Oh, yeah, we are recording this, right? Oh, good. I see the thumbs up. Also, since I saw you the last time, I have worked with Fraggles and I've worked with a Muppet.
Really?
And
and you feel like you can do both of those things and you're not cheating on one or the other?
I feel like it's okay. I feel like the Fraggles would be more upset that I was cheating with the Muppet than the Muppet would probably not care.
The Muppets are like, do whatever you want, man.
I don't care.
I'm a bleeping Muppet.
I don't need this.
Yeah. But which Muppet was it?
It was the chef, Swedish Chef.
He's pretty good. Did you talk to him about his accent?
We talked a little bit, yeah. Yeah,
it's actually a Norwegian accent.
Is it? Oh, really?
The Swedes get
so the
really
Swedes
pissed.
Tell us. Yeah.
We made a record in Sweden. Our second album was made in Sweden. The first thing they said, they were like, "What do you know about Sweden?" And we're like, meatballs, Swedish Chef. And they're like, "That guy is Norwegian." they get really mad.
Norwegian Chef just doesn't have the same.
I know.
It just doesn't have the
same. Doesn't seem to it.
Swedes are. You think? I don't know. I feel like, you know, like Tim could say, like, that's so French about the question mark. You say something so Spanish or so British. And it's like, you kind of know the basic culture of most European countries, right?
For the most part, yeah. It's or at least Sweden, we have some understanding.
When we spent 3 months there, and there's a much more intense culture. Like, there are lots of things I didn't know about it. Like, like for instance, the way they end, like, if I was talking to you right now and you wanted to be like, like, kind of just nod me along while I'm going, instead of doing you go,
oh,
what?
It's really weird.
That's strange. Are they summoning something?
No, I thought everybody had, like, a cognitive disorder. I was like, well, how have we
They're
found...
breathing in the words and the information.
It's
like how we say, you know.
Yeah, like, or But so the very first day we met our producer on that record, the second album, the record was called Oh No, and we made it in 2004, I think. We played a show in London, and he came to see us in London like the day before we were going to the studio. And they're also extremely comfortable with silence in a way that most Americans aren't, and especially not me. So we're like at the show, super amped up, had this great show. Like, what do you think of the show? He's like, it's very good.
So, of course, you're reading that as, oh, it's...
And just, like, literally, we sat there in silence for, like, 10 minutes, and I was like, so do you have any pets? I mean, like, I didn't know what to ask at all.
Yeah, and he was like, yes, one. Why?
And so, of course, being the idiot I am, I just sort of, like, tried to fill the silence. Like, well, I think we should make the record this way. I think we should do that. And the whole time, it was just like...
So not only are you not getting anything from him that you have grown to expect from just basic American interpersonal communication, but what you're getting is actually a weird series of slurpy sounds.
And if the farther north you go, I may have it backwards now, but the more they add a fricative in, then they go like, and I was like,
and the further north, also they only really communicate that way, right? Like, to save energy because it's so cold. That's what they told us.
That's what they told us.
That's what they told us.
But, so yeah, no, I really was like, this is a version of Tourette's I've never seen. And then like, his assistant was next to him doing the same thing. I was like, maybe it's a disease. Like, maybe we're going to go to this studio and catch this weird, like, brain disease.
Or it's like a body snatchers thing where they've all been taken over.
Snatched.
Filipinos, when they try to get each other's attention, go, tss, tss. That's what they do.
Well, that's kind of like, psst.
Yeah, but right? It's like, but it's loud and not trying to be like our psst is like, secretive. Hey, I got a secret.
Yeah,
this is like I've seen like, you know, kids doing this to their friends like across a, you know.
It's like, yo.
Yeah, exactly.
It's so hard to do everything right in America.
Do you remember they told us they hold the world record for the most number one world records? Apparently.
Are you serious?
That's what they told us.
That's just Tor's sense of humor.
Yeah.
So our producer was this guy who's so quiet. It turns out he's one of the funniest guys we've ever met. He's just extremely dry. And so he like, I don't think I saw him smile the entire time, but he was never not telling a joke.
Okay. You know?
So it's like, Sweden holds the world record in world records. That's like his joke, and he just walks away.
But
the whole time I was there, I was like, wow, that's so cool. There's the most world records. I didn't know he was kidding at the time.
And then
it took me until like 3 days ago to know.
Oh, by the way, we don't do
Yeah, yes, I made
we
that
don't
up too.
Do that too.
Yeah.
I'm surprised you didn't say anything about it.
Yeah, I mean, I would think that was weird if someone made those noises to me.
It was pretty weird. Indian people do this to me. Yes, I'm radio listeners.
They let left and right.
It's left and right. It's the same thing you would do if I was like, did you like that show? And it was like your friend, but it was really crappy show. And you're like, well,
I mean, you know, it was, yeah, you guys, like, the sound was weird.
So I like, and I was in India. I was in India for like a month, a couple years ago, and you basically are required to have a driver. You should, because it's crazy. They drive crazy. And I was like asking our driver, like, do you think we could stop for food? And he's like, I'm like, why, how can this guy tell me? Like, I don't know. Like, all month it was like that. I never got used to someone being like, this is yes.
Wow. Did you ever confront someone and go, oh, because we do this?
Yeah, I was like, why? Listen, I understand that there's several billion of you in this country, but don't you understand that America made up a different thing for that?
Yeah. Why can't you have the courtesy to adapt to my foreign ways?
Our necks don't do that.
Yeah. My neck doesn't move that way. And plus, you I mean, if you start doing that in those call centers, man, people are like...
They're not going to...
Yeah, we've already outsourced all our jobs.
So no one's going to know what's happening at that point. By the way, congratulations on the new video, which is fucking insane.
Thank you.
I mean, literally, I always feel a little stressed out for you guys. I'm like, how are they going to top that last one? How do you go up for, I mean, do you feel that pressure?
It's nice that someone feels stressed.
Yeah.
We're usually so relaxed.
It's just really relaxed. Making news is a super relaxing process for us.
It's really easy, right?
Yeah. Now, this one was great because we had 4 shoot days in August in Tokyo when it never, ever rains. So it's exactly why you can use this indoor vehicle, which you're not really supposed to take outside, and you're definitely not supposed to get it wet. Mm-hmm. Or use a flying drone, which you could never get wet or fly in the rain. So we just had rain for the first 3.5 of those shoot days. Yeah. It was like, we're just sitting there like, at least we had a lot of extra rehearsal time.
Oh,
you know?
Fuck.
It was, every video has that moment for some reason.
Yeah.
The Rube Goldberg one that we shot here in Los Angeles, shot in Echo Park.
I know that space. My wife works in that space now.
Really?
Yeah. Really? An animation house called 6 Point Harness now has that space.
Cool.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Hi, 6 Point Harness. Do they have electricity currently?
It took them a long time to get all the stuff up to code.
We understand why.
Yeah. There was, because 11 hours before our shoot started, a drunk driver hit the junction box or whatever it is right outside the building, and there was just no electricity.
Oh, jeez.
And we were like, you know, this was like going to be the all-nighter where we finished the whole thing and everything. And so we all go out in the parking lot where people's cars can light up. We can sort of work out there for a minute. And a guy who was high on PCP started attacking the crew and started jumping up and down on people's cars, like literally like, you know, like crushing in people's hoods and stuff like that. So everybody runs back inside. And then he started picking up our power tools out there and throwing them at the door.
Sure.
And so there's no electricity. It's like cold and dank and weird in there. They're like the police are on their way, and we have a homicidal maniac pounding the door.
I think I understand why you named your band what you did, because it's all the stopping and starting. Oh, okay, go.
Yeah.
Wait. Okay, go. Wait. Okay, go. Okay, go.